Two women from Wisconsin are facing domestic terrorism charges today.
They're accused of taking part in an attack against Atlanta police on Monday afternoon. CBS 58's Yukari Nakayama is here in the studio with details about the women and what happened. Yukari.
Yeah, Mike, Amanda, 19-year-old Kaylee Meisner and 22-year-old Grace Martin are the two Wisconsin women arrested and facing those serious terrorism charges. Atlanta police describing them as a group of violent agitators. Atlanta police say on Sunday, a group of, quote, violent agitators who used the cover of a peaceful protest attacked the proposed Atlanta Public Safety Training Center, where allegedly large rocks and even Molotov cocktails were thrown. Equipment set ablaze.
This wasn't about a public safety training center. This was about anarchy, and this was about the attempt to destabilize.
Tuesday morning, police released the identities of 23 people facing domestic terrorism charges for this attack. Police say only two were based in Georgia, the rest all over the country, including Kaylee Meisner and Grace Martin from Wisconsin. CBS 58 has learned that Meisner, just 19 years old, was a daycare teacher in Madison. Her father says this behavior is not typical of Kaylee and has tried to reach her since last night. 22-year-old Grace Martin's last known address is in Marathon County. According to reports, the attack on the Atlanta Safety Training Center, deemed Cop City, came after pushback from activists and protesters who believe the center will be an environmental and social concern for the community.
We don't want more repression of black people. We don't want more polluted air. We don't want less green space in our community. We don't want more policing and terrorizing of black, brown, indigenous bodies in our community.
We say no to Cop City, and we say no to this history.
And according to police, no officers were hurt during the attack on Sunday. Now, I have reached out to Grace Martin's family and have not received a response. In the studio, Yukari Nakayama, CBS 58 News.